toil you will eat of it in all the days of your life. It will produce thorns and thistles for you. Thorns and thistles are curses. Mm. So right then and there, when man was deceived from not obeying what the Lord had told him to do, that's when we were born into sin. And that's where we need to repent, because the kingdom of God is near. And if we don't repent, he too will perish. Mm. So that leads us to the Great Commission. Once again, the Lord told his disciples in Matthew 28:16-20. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said to all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to Jesus, to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age. So now, since you guys have knowledge of the Great Commission, we are obligated to obey what the Lord has told us to do, to go out and reach out into the world, into the byways and highways, and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. The other day, Brother William said, it's not for us to save the man, but to preach the gospel to him.
All creation is going to preach the gospel.
See, all we can do is share the word. God does all the rest.
Praise God.
The problem comes on when we decide ourselves that we can save them, and we can convert them, and we can do everything. And when we do it, it messes everything up. Because we're not qualified. We're not authorized to do that. We're only qualified and authorized to what? Tell our testimony and the testimony of Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit does everything else.
Praise God. So in closing, you know, we can't do what society wants us to do, because we're pressured and peer pressured by darkness in this world, because darkness runs this world right now. Only for a little while, because Jesus is coming back to rule. And so we can't be of this world.
You can be in the world, but not of the world.
Amen. So we can't be influenced by the society, by our Gentiles, by the peers. But taught by the Spirit and walk in the Spirit, because that is our comforter. That is our guide, our protector. That's our rock.
And where do you do all this? On your knees. That's the biggest, that's the most powerful position of a Christian.
You do it in a relationship with the Lord.
Exactly.
That's how you do it, with the relationship with the Lord. By asking Him simply, Lord, I hear these words that were spoken today. I may not understand them. I may not know what's going on, but I feel something. Mm-hmm. Lord God, please come into my life. Help me. Mm-hmm. Protect me. I'm scared. Mm-hmm. Guide me.
Yeah.
I believe what Jesus did on that cross.
But you got to mean it, you know? Otherwise, it just becomes lip service. Amen. How many times have you heard lip service in this world? You all been to prison. Let's face it, you all there. How many people give lip service? You know, am I right or wrong? You know, let's face it, we all do that. I'll never do that again, Judge. I'll never do that. I won't do that until they walk away. Oh, yeah. And he's lucky I didn't get mad. And what the problem is, we got to make sure we don't do that with God. God doesn't want to say, you know, oh, I love you, God. Yeah, right.
And it said in Matthew 15:8, see, these people draw nigh to me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. So it's the same thing. We speak with our mouth, but we're not meaning with our heart, you know.
And that's what God sees, is what's in our heart. He can read that like a book. You know?
That we've shared. We thank you for the opportunity to be able to fellowship, Father God, and speak truth into each other's lives, Father God. Speak wisdom and knowledge, Father God. Truth from the Bible, Father God. May understanding and wisdom come from the Spirit of God, but not from man, but from God, Father. And we pray that you discipline us, Father God, to take heed and listen to the Spirit of God. With that said, Father God, I pray that you bless us. You bless this ministry, Father God. You bless anybody that comes into view of this ministry, Father God. Bring them closer to Jesus Christ, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, I do pray. Amen.
Amen.